And welcome back to the second lesson on using multiple LEDs. So this is the program that we wrote in the previous lesson. So we're just going to expand on this. By the way, just a useful trick, if you want to remove a program that's running on the Arduino and you don't want to, you want to clear it out sort of, and you don't want it to run anymore, all you can do is you can just delete everything that you've written basically, and then you just verify that and just upload it to Arduino. Yeah, and that will remove any program that you are writing on the Arduino. Essentially what you're doing with this is that you're just giving it an empty script. So if you remember our actor example, it's like you giving the actor a blank paper. There's nothing to read, therefore there's nothing to do. And another trick, the undo button is not shown clearly on this interface. It's if you remove something and you want to put it back. So what I just did now, I deleted that whole program that we wrote before. So you can right click and then select undo, or so that you right click and then undo. Or a quick shortcut that I like using is you press Control Z, and you see that it brings up everything. And if you redid something and you want to redo it again, you can just say Control Y. So now I want to undo that, so I'm going to go Control Z, and your program comes back. Now the undo will not work if you saved your program before. A shortcut to saving your work, so every time that you write your code, always save, because in case your PC crashes, you will lose the work that you've done. A quick shortcut to saving is pressing Control S and it'll save. Or you can go to File up here at the top and then click Save. So this saves your code. In case you lose power, you can always go back to your documents and reopen this project. Okay, so the aim of this lesson is that we're going to make the three LEDs come on at different times, but not at the same time. Kind of like how a traffic light system works. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to turn on the green and then we turn it off, then turn on the yellow, then turn the yellow off, and then immediately when the yellow turns off, the red must come on. So that's the program that we're going to be writing today. Then just a trick that I want to show you, so let me just remove everything here because we're starting from fresh, and I just want to give you a quick trick. So usually in our setup, when we start our program setting up everything, we say we do pin mode, and let's use number 9, which is the green LED. So just keep in mind that number 9 is the green LED. Just means that we've connected the green LED to pin number 9. And then we say that is an output. And then we end our semicolon. Always put the semicolon. And then what we did here was we made a comment with the double forward slash, and then we say green. We said green LED. And that was fine. But then now one of the problems that you're going to face is that you're going to have maybe 13 LEDs that you are controlling, or you're going to be, say with our robots, we're going to have a lot of sensors that we are controlling, and maybe motors and whatever. So we're going to have multiple systems that we are controlling with our pins. And the thing is, it's going to be very hard or difficult to keep in mind that, oh okay, I connected the green LED to pin number 9, oh my word, and then I connected, did I connect the other one maybe to pin number 8, I don't know, I forgot, whatever. So to help you with that to avoid that problem, what we do is there's a trick called hash define. So let me just remove this and show that to you. What hash define does is it takes a word and links it to a certain number, so that every time the Arduino sees that particular word, it immediately thinks of the number that you gave to that word. So an example of this, let's just do an example and then I'll explain further. So that instruction, we say hash define, then it comes green, meaning that the Arduino knows what we're doing. And in this case, we want to tell the Arduino that, okay, the green LED is connected to pin number 9. So what you do here is we're gonna write green, we're gonna leave a space, and then we say number 9. And we put our semicolon. What this instruction says is that every time, Mr. Arduino, every time you see the word green, replace that word with the number 9. And that's what we're gonna do. So since this is in the void setup, it does this once. So everywhere in the code where you're gonna use the word green, the Arduino immediately changes that to number 9. This is useful so that you as a programmer don't have to remember. Remember that you want to do as less work as possible while programming and while your system is running. So you want the machine to do the thinking for you. That's what we're doing. So now remembering the word green is very easy for us. So we can do the same thing now. We have a yellow LED. So let's just say hash define comes green, and we're gonna say yellow. And then yellow is connected to pin number 8. So we're gonna say 8, close brackets, I mean semicolon. So now every time the Arduino sees the word yellow, it will replace that with the number 8. So it just references the word to the number. And then the other thing that we have is hash define. We have a red LED, which is our red light, and that is connected to pin number 7. Okay, and I'm just good OCD. I love everything to be in line sometimes. So that. Okay, so this n tells the Arduino that every time you see the word red, put the number 7. So when you've done this, you generally don't want to use the word red in your code for anything else, because now using the word red means that it's associated with pin number 7. Then another useful thing that you can do is while you're writing your code, if you get confused maybe, or you're stuck, or you think maybe, will this understand my instruction? Remember here, like, you can make as many mistakes as you want, it's still fine. This is not school, you're not gonna get penalized for this. What you can do is you can just click verify, and it'll just check that what you've written so far, does it really make sense? So I clicked verify, and then it didn't come up with any errors. Again, if we had forgotten to put the semicolon, or maybe spelled hash define incorrectly, and we tried to verify that, immediately we get errors, and you know where the error is. Oh, okay, I spelled that incorrectly, and I don't have my semicolon here. And then you verify again, and it's fine. So this is as you're typing, if you're not sure if you're writing correctly, or you're using the right syntax, which is the grammar, or you miss something, or you don't know how it works, just always say verify, and then it checks it for you. If you get an error, big deal. You can Google maybe what's the problem. Yeah, but then it's you usually would find that you spelled the instruction incorrect, and or you have the semicolon wrong. And if you for hash define, it strictly needs to be in this format. So you can't put the number, for example, so you can't put the number first. It will not understand. Let's verify that. You see, it doesn't understand what that means. You're telling it now that every time you see the number 9, put the word green. It doesn't really understand what green means. It's not in its vocab. So let's just go ahead and put that correctly again. So we're telling it, remember that it can understand numbers more than it can understand words. So we're just gonna verify that it should be fine. and voila, it's fine. Okay, let's go in. So now we've made our setup hash defined. So now we can, so remember our legendary pin mode instruction. Let's rewrite that. So pin mode. Now instead of saying pin mode 9 output, we know that okay, we're setting up our green LED. So let's just write green here. It's gonna be, as humans understand green very better. Imagine like always thinking that okay, every time I want to use the green LED, I must put the number 9. Alrighty, so yeah, so now instead of, so here we, you see green, but the computer or the Arduino or your robot sees 9. So that's what we've done. So this is very convenient for us. No, you don't have to remember everything. Now, if it happens here that you spell the word wrong, like what I've done here, I have Xian here. I didn't define Xian anywhere at the top. So if I verify this, it's gonna be incorrect. So try verify that, and it says that I don't understand what Hien means or if it's Gien. So I need to correct that. I need to put an R here so that it's green. Then I'm gonna verify that, and it's giving me more problems here. So the tricky thing about this one is because it does not, if I read the error at the bottom, it's very difficult to see what the problem is. So remember that I said that you can always verify and see if it's happy with your syntax, because if I verify this here, it's still giving me problems. So I know that everything here is correct because I've been using this before. So something's clearly wrong over here. And so to try and work back from this, what you can do is, if you're in a case like this and you're doubting this instruction, I usually Google and then see what am I missing from this. So as you can see, it's difficult to figure this out. And if you Google this and you see what is wrong with this instruction, or maybe Google hash define on Arduino, you're gonna see that the hash define instruction does not really require a semicolon. So if you remove the semicolon over here, so it's not like the other instruction. If you remove the semicolon, it will be happy. And it's happy with that. So what I always recommend that you do is, and with, as we're coding, we're going to see a lot of beautiful errors, and the errors are a very good way for us to learn how the pro or how the software works. So now we know that there are cases where we don't have to use our semicolon, but then those cases are very rare, kind of like this one. So the errors, you must be grateful of errors because they help you to learn more, and I encourage you to make as many mistakes as you can with this. That's when you learn more. Another thing, if you want to avoid writing down a whole program and then finding out there's errors in the end, you can always type one line and then click verify. One line and then click verify. But I live on the edge, so I'm one of those guys. The greatest feeling in the world of programming is writing your code right through and having it run without errors. When you get into the programming, you're gonna find that's very cool. Okay, so let's move on with the lesson. So what we've learned from this is the hash define. This just takes, every time it sees the word green, it puts number 9, yellow it puts number 8, and then red it puts number 7. If you remember the previous instructions over here, we had numbers. Now we don't have to remember numbers. We just write everything as it is on our physical setup. We know we have the green LED, yellow LED, And the other error that we learned was that if you spell this thing, if you spell the words wrong, incorrectly, as you had declared them before, your Arduino will not make sense of it. Then the third thing we learned was that if you put semicolon for this special instructions, I mean for this special instruction, it does not like that. Okay, so those are the things that we keep in mind. And remember that when it does this, it never comes back here. So these settings are gonna stay permanent for the software that we're gonna be writing.